Come here. Come here. Confusion. To commotion. What don't it is to our devotion. Set the bridge big. Big the ocean.
You're in charge. You're in charge.
Save your prediction.
Can you hear it? I'm all by myself to... Aw, man, you blew the bit. Oh, no pants today, huh?
Went back to the no pants.
Here, your drink's there.
I just got out of the shower.
Oh, grabbing my chalky.
Sorry I'm late.
What's up, everybody? We're back!
There you go.
I got a lot of energy today.
Too much, some might say.
The last few days I've been a little tired, but today, maybe it's the guests got me excited. Big fan of Rose McIver. I call her MacGyver.
Okay.
Not McIver. MacGyver. Like the TV series.
Original.
Is that a piece of hair right there?
Where? What?
Ooh.
On my glass? Are you serious? Where?
Ooh!
Where?
I'm kidding. There isn't one, but I know it bothers you.
It bothers me so much.
That is
hair in something?
That is a fresh, cold glass of chocolate milk today, babies.
And that is a $19 glass of orange juice.
Yeah, we finally got orange juice today. We were feeling it. Real quick, welcome to the show.
Relax.
We're super excited. We got a new show today. We went out today. We fucking geared up, sprayed up. We had to make a stop and get some resources for the week. Good morning from Australia. What's up, Australia?
We needed some supplies, and Richard Harmon did not have... Well, anything, really. So we did a delivery to Richard.
We did a distance
delivery to Dickie.
Delivery.
We dropped it off out front. I sprayed it with Lysol, backed away, and then Rhiannon and Richard came out, put gloves on, and then picked it up.
That's the first time in my life I've seen Dickie in person and didn't give that boy a hug.
No
hug. And it was hard.
Classic Richard, indeed, Quill. Classic
Richard. Oh, also a reminder, after the show today, at 7 p.m. Pacific, Quill. Look at this.
Quilly.
Look at these tricks I know now. Follow Classic Richard. Post something about your show or just say, hi, I'm Quill. Cooking with Quill.
7:30. Quill does a cooking show every night at 7:30. He gives you the ingredients, super simple stuff. Quill on the Grill.
Quill on the Grill. It's very entertaining. It's sassy.
Very entertaining.
It's sexy.
We've watched a few episodes. We haven't cooked along with him yet.
Next week.
We're going to do a crossover episode next week. So we'll figure out what day, and then we'll probably put out the, we'll have Quill on to talk about it on our show, and then later that night, we'll be on Quill's show, cooking along with Quill on the Grill.
If it goes well for us, we're probably going to steal Quill's show. And push him right out.
I don't have that much
and
energy.
Take all his money.
I can sit in front of
you
the
and I
fireplace,
don't cook anyways.
And we're not much in the cooking department, so we have a few things to learn from Quill.
Our first guest,
and our only guest today,
a co-star of Jessica Harmon on iZombie. A huge film and television star. A Kiwi.
She's a Kiwi.
I'm a big fan of hers, simply because of the stuff you told me about working with her. Not even because of her acting, but be how she handles herself on set. We'll talk about
that. Wonderful.
I genuinely don't really like her acting.
He hates her acting.
Yeah, I watch her and I'm like, ugh.
Oh, he hates her.
But I dig that she seems like a good person and very, very sweet.
To work with, yes.
Yeah, her acting is just...
hates her. There's nothing Lenny hates more than...
She comes on the screen
Rose
and I'm like,
MacGyver
oh, here thing. She comes.
Yeah.
Dick face, MacGyver.
That was weird.
Yeah, that was
too far.
No, I love her.
She's an angel. Thing.
Her song today is from the week that she was born. It was the number one hit on... it was the number one song in the U.S. And I should have done the number one song in New Zealand.
Yeah.
Yeah, but our show isn't in New Zealand. On October 10th, 1988, this little cutie came into the world, and the song was... Wait, where is it? And the song was...
Oh, it's Josh Knepper's birthday. Happy birthday, bro.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first guest... Oh, you know what? Does she not know how to do... Does she not know how to...
She might not know how this works. She might not know how it works. Give her a minute to figure it out.
I thought she was in because I was saying all that stuff
about her.
But it doesn't really hold up if she wasn't even in the room.
Now it's just real.
Now it's just rude.
Yeah.
All right, she's got to come in. Hold on, guys.
No.
Did you just see her?
No.
Well, close out. She's probably not going to... Guys, it's a live show. Anything can happen.
Did you text her?
She's seen it. Come in the show, and then we add you. Here she comes.
She's coming.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Well, no, I don't know that she's here yet. She's not here yet.
Does she know what that means? You gotta click on.
Just tell her.
Click on the live show.
She's here.
All right, wait, ladies and gentlemen.
She's here. Oh, there she is.
This song is from October, the day you were born. The whole intro got ruined. October 10th, 1988.
This was the biggest song in the U.S.
The number one song in the.
In the country. Little McIver was born.
Country.
Mm-hmm. I'm not surprised. Still is in my books.
Still is. It might actually have just arrived in New Zealand, actually.
I wonder what the number one song was in New Zealand that I was born.
Yeah, we can let we'll have
you
a,
know what?
Our fact checker. You weren't
in the room. And as I was introducing your song, I was like, it was the number one song in the I should have done New Zealand. Hold on, let me see how you two talk.
Oh. Hello.
Hi, guys.
How are you doing?
I was actually on for quite a while. I kept throwing in, like, highs, and some people below, like, saw, but I think it just looks
here.
Like you just have so many subscribers that
there's
I got lost in the...
There's so many subscribers.
God, it's huge. We're both Kardashians.
Honestly, when Ellen couldn't do her show any longer, the people, they came to us, so we
keeping
have...
Keeping up with the Harmon Jacobsons, this could
that's
be an
awesome right
title.
Yeah, which is impossible, so...
I'm so close.
Oh,
wow, there's
like a whole
Wikipedia.
Oh, you're
going to
find it and then play it.
You don't look entirely excited
about the song, Tris.
I've never heard of it, but maybe
Rose has. Hold on. What is
it?
Kiwi song. Oh, here we go. Maybe we'll recognize it.
All right.
Maybe a Kiwi song.
I can't find it. This would have been the number one song a week later. So as you were being...
You were like coming home. Your first week at home.
Coming home. Yeah,
and like this
that. Hit the vibe.
Desire, you too.
Oh.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, really?
That's a good song.
Yeah.
I think I'll take Red, Red Wine still.
Yeah.
That's more my vibe. I think I knew I was going to end up living here, you know?
Yeah, and drinking your red wine.
Rose, how are you?
How are you?
Guys, I'm good. I'm actually kind of good. I'm fine. I'm very lucky. I made banana bread today.
Wow.
I've been saving it.
You know,
the other day, when I said you were going to be on, I was like, I think there's going to be crafts during her show. I think there should be cooking. Mm-hmm. I think there might be some music. I think there
this
might
needle
be some...
from my crafts?
Oh, you brought a sewing needle.
Yeah.
No, it's just I'm sitting with my craft station, which is right next to me.
Okay, perfect. Just in case. You never know when you might need to craft.
I'm in my gardening attire. I'm not glamorous. I came ready for an at-home chat. How are you guys going?
Got my mask. We're good. It was odd. I was here working. Here is Vancouver. So I was in Vancouver working. He was in Los Angeles working. And then everything went down, as you are aware of, like simultaneously and very quickly. So I was going to fly home. And then we thought, because my terrible immune system, I don't know if you remember an iZombie, I was probably sick, like half this, like just always sick, get sick a lot.
Yeah.
It was like very weak immune system. Weak person, but strong-minded, weak physical.
Real piece of shit,
exactly.
Yeah.
So I was like, let's not have me fly, and let's have you fly, and then come here instead, because also we just thought, you know, maybe being here, my family's all here right now, kind of made sense at the time, and then they shut down the planes, or some of them. Lenny was on one of the planes that got, like, nope, never
mind. Supposed to be.
He was supposed to be flying up on the Sunday, and on Saturday they were like, hey, nah. Literally, that's exactly.
So I drove.
Him the message. So he got in the car as soon as they texted him in the middle of the day on Saturday, like 1 in the afternoon, just grabbed Belouche, grabbed some clothes, got in the car, and drove at Canada, and made it a couple of days before they closed the borders.
I was going to say, did you stay on the way up?
I drove as long as I could. I stayed in one place in Redding, California.
I
wiped the handle of the door. I slowly in. I didn't want to. I wiped the bathroom. I wiped the counters. I slept in the bed. I mean, I would imagine it was probably okay. And,
yeah.
And then he's been here like.
Are you in the States? Are you in
LA? Right.
I'm in LA. George is here. My boyfriend's upstairs in the loft, which we've converted into an office space. Well, it's like, it was kind of an office space anyway, but he's working from home. I was supposed to be doing a show and got told whatever, who knows what's going to happen.
Yeah.
But the thing is for me, like, I don't know. I mean, it's obviously terrible. It's a terrible situation. I just feel like my personal experience is so safe and good, and my parents are at home, they're together, they're out of harm's way. I feel like if I stop and think about medical professionals or people who have really compromised immune systems or, it's very easy to get very depressed. But my actual day-to-day experience is, I can't complain about anything. I get to just be at home and be outside. And so I am trying to, like, stay optimistic. I can kind of fall into getting a little bit grim anyway, so I'm just trying really hard not to tune in too much to unnecessary hysteria. Like, I'm watching
the
news every night. I watch Judy Woodruff, my favorite PBS, just the news, and that kind of gives me what I actually need to know in a day, but staying off like just the constant updates, which just keep you in the state of, like,
that's the smart choice, I think. I was, like, at the beginning, like, before he got here, I was on every news cycle, like, Twitter nonstop, like, everything that was happening. Because I kind of made aware of it through a friend who was, like, has a son-in-law who's one of the world's leading microbiologists. So he kind of knew a while back and was like, this is going to become a problem, and North America's not really paying attention to it, or they're not at least like discussing it to the extent
that it's going
to
get bigger
right now. It's going to be
you were ahead of the game.
So I knew like a month before any of this happened, I was already told like shit's going to get weird. But I was up here, I was directing, and I was like, and finishing. Not allowed to say, but I'll text you.
Okay.
And it was
fabulous. It's very exciting. And so I was
I'm glad you got that off before the lockdown, whatever it is.
Yes, exactly.